All right, so we're out in the garage here. We just fit our tub. We installed the levelers. But now, before we put the mortar in and put the tub in, it's always easier to install the drain before we put it in. Otherwise, if you have an empty wall here, maybe you're framing it in for the first time, this would be maybe an easier spot, but you'll need access to the bottom as well as the back of the tub. So just make sure before you put it in, before you put in mortar, before you screw it in, make sure that you either have room to put the tub drain in, or that you can get to it. So first off, we're gonna start with the drain. So this is what's gonna go inside. And we talked about the stopper. This is nice because you can just push it and it closes the stopper and then undo it. So we don't need to have the system that they had before, which was a big chain that held the stopper and where you could turn it off. So I'm gonna unscrew that, and then this will expose the actual unit here. So what's gonna happen is this is gonna go underneath the tub, and then this is gonna go over top the tub. And really what's gonna happen is they're just gonna get screwed in together. And so the other components to this are a rubber washer that will go on the bottom. So this will sit underneath the tub, and then this will sit above the tub. And then right in between this metal and the tub, we can either use plumber's putty or we can use silicone. And now there's a big debate between plumbers and do-it-yourself people, as well as just general contractors, is what is better, plumber's putty or this stuff, or the caulk or the silicone. And so in my experience, I've seen the plumber's putty dry out, and so it dries out and cracks. And then what'll happen is it'll fall out, and then you could have leaking. Typically, your silicone won't do that. It'll stay really, really flexible for a long, long time. The issue is that it's harder to work with. It squirts out all over the place when you're trying to work, and it's a little bit harder to clean up. The plumber's putty, on the other hand, just goes right in there, and it's very easy. The excess you peel off and use it for later. So we're gonna use the silicone for this project, but if you wanna use plumber's putty, that is completely fine. And what you'll do is you'll pop it open. And it's just like working with Play-Doh. It starts off pretty tough, and it is pretty cold here, but basically you grab a section out and you just work it in your hands. So yeah, you know, this kind of reminds you of working with Play-Doh or whatnot. And so what you're gonna do is you're gonna form a ring around this. And so you can just lay it on there. And what's nice is, like I said, this is pretty firm material, and so it won't squirt out like the silicone will. And so when we go and tighten this down, this putty is actually gonna squirt out, and then we'll just come by and tear off the excess, and it's pretty easy to work with. But like I said, I have seen it in the past dry out, and then it's not super effective and it doesn't do its job. So. If you're really interested, talk to some plumbers, do some more research yourself about what you think is the best product for you. But in the meanwhile, we're gonna start up here. So I'm gonna get into the tub, and I'm gonna put a pretty heavy bead of silicone here. So put this guy down just so I can gauge where I'm gonna be, and then I'm gonna get the silicone in there. So I like to go pretty heavy with it to start, and then just clean up the excess. Let's get in there. So I like to use the clear stuff that smells really bad, and you need mineral spirits to clean it up. There's a lot of different caulks out there. Some are for painting, some are for just general stuff, but you want kind of the toughest stuff that you can get. So I'm gonna put it on really heavy and then worry about cleanup later, because I'd rather have a lot of it squirt out and have a good seal than otherwise.
Okay.
What I'm also gonna do is throw a little bit of bead on here. Good to go. And once again with this, we are going to be threading this into here. So I'm gonna use a little bit more of our tape. If you remember this from our other examples, and this is just our Teflon tape, and this is just gonna go around here. It helps seals any threaded parts. And so each of your tubs will come with an installation manual, and I would say follow the manufacturer's recommendations. And if they conflict with this, then that's okay. Do whatever they say. That's typically the best way to install anything. So I'm gonna wrap this around the threads. Now we're ready to go. Now it's kind of messy now. Like I said, if this were plumber's putty, this would be a little bit cleaner. All right, so I'm gonna insert this with one hand, and then on the other hand, I've got this. And so I'm just gonna rest it in there for now. Okay. I'm just gonna let it go, and then I'm gonna come around here and grab my my rubber gasket. So this is gonna go underneath, like that. And so if you want to, you can go ahead and plop a little extra sealant on this. This you definitely don't need as much. This is almost just like a little bit of glue to help things out. So same thing, I can also do it to the top side here. Okay. Now we're gonna get under here and see how it goes. Okay. So this is gonna be facing this way. And then from the top, you're gonna slowly turn this guy, or from the bottom, whichever works. And so the biggest thing here is you wanna make sure you don't cross-thread it by accident. And if you remember the tool we had from last time, this will help us to thread this through from the top side. If you had a buddy, this would be a great time to ask your buddy for some help, so he could hold it and you could screw it. Tighten this. And so as you can see, the silicone is coming out, and that is fine. Like I said, though, we are gonna have some extra cleanup that you wouldn't normally have with the putty. And as it gets tighter, you just want to feel for centered and make sure you are doing good. At the same time, make sure that this pipe is coming out in the right direction. And then I always like to go in there and inspect everything. Make sure that your seals and your gaskets are doing good, and then go ahead and clean up any of the excess gunk you have in there. So, like I said, that's what's kind of the downside of the silicone. Okay, so now that that's good, I'm just gonna clean it up with a little paper towel, maybe get some mineral spirits on it. You just wanna protect the tub at all times. And then we're gonna go on to our next step of installing this top spout, the overflow right here. All right, the next part is the overflow drain. So this is gonna be our drain at the top. All of your tubs should have this. And it's gonna be obviously if any water gets too high, it'll overflow down into the drain. So a lot of the drains will be just kind of put right here. This is just a special drain. It allows a little bit more water in the tub. And so basically what this unit is here is water will allow to come in here and then drip, and then we'll all connect in one little area. So this one specifically says to grab, and like I said, this is all about your installation instructions. This one has some double-sided tape. So just to help things align a little bit better. So it just wants us to put a little bit of double-sided tape under the gasket. And then we'll stick the gasket to this double-sided tape. So it's just gonna help in actually keeping the unit together as we install. All right, so last piece of double-sided tape off. And now we're just gonna seat this on top of this. So just be careful, read your directions, see which way it needs to go on. So like I said, this double-sided tape really isn't doing much. It's just helping in installation. Now I can dip it up and down and it won't fall off. And so the directions say to go ahead and put a little bead of silicone. So we'll do that. And as you saw before, be quite a task to clean up. So be prepared. And so this particular model has a mounting plate up here. And it's just a metal plate that is going to help spread the load. It's almost like a washer. And so I'm going to align this, and this has a specifically wedge shape to it. So it's actually going to sit like that under the unit and help everything connect. So I can start by hand threading these screws. Other screw in there, and like we said, your unit might be completely different, so just check with your manufacturer instructions and base everything off of that. Okay, so I'm going to slowly tighten things down, not getting too tight to start, because that'll allow me some time and room to reposition things. And the biggest thing is really just making sure that your gasket is on there properly and seated well, and then you can go ahead and tighten it. And that will do it. So ours has a little cover that you put over it, so it looks a little bit better, but we're gonna skip that step for the sake of the film and move on to connecting these two pieces. Okay, so our last piece here is just the connector. It connects the overflow to the regular drain and then puts it out all into one drain. So I'm gonna go here and slightly move one of our pipes back a little bit and bring it into place. So the biggest thing is just, does everything align properly? And these happen to be all compression fittings. And so the easiest way is to really loosen everything up all the way. So that's actually what's going on. There we go. So these, how these work is they just, when you tighten down on the screw, there we go. It squeezes everything together. So you can tell there's a slight angle to this one. And we're just going to tighten it down. And these should just be hand tight. So same thing here. If you can see, this is actually going to wedge into the pipe. And that's what is keeping everything tight. So they aren't the best. I like glue a lot better. But in some circumstances, they are necessary. Typically when you have joints that need to be flexible or sliding up and down. Okay, so that's good to go. And we have this little bit right here too. So for the actual installation of this, I might take this little piece out. This is just an extension. And then I can always thread this back up from under the floor. So for this, because we're going to have to handle this a little bit, so I'm going to take it out for now. And then when I go back up on the floor, we'll install this, and then our pipes will connect to it. Okay, so we just finished setting our tub in the mortar. It's ready to go, and now we're working on the underside to connect our drainage. So, if you remember, this is just a little extension piece that I removed from the tub while we were handling it so that we didn't break it off. So, this is just gets threaded up inside of here. Yours may or may not have this piece. That is nice and snug. And now, just to talk a little bit, that was a black ABS pipe. And as you can see throughout the rest of the house, there is this white PVC pipe. There's some differences between the ABS and the PVC. Typically, your ABS is thinner pipe, it's a little bit cheaper, and it's black. PVC is a little bit more expensive, and it's white, and it's a little bit thicker. So, technically, PVC is probably the best product, and so that's one reason that we like to use it. But the issue is that I'm going from black ABS into white PVC, and technically, you can use a ABS to PVC transition glue, and this is green. This isn't acceptable in a lot of areas. The code doesn't permit it, and so this is one way you could do it, but you would definitely need to check with your codes. Another way might be to use like a Fernco coupler, and so this basically would slip onto one end of the pipe and then slip onto the other, and you just tighten down the screws and the nuts here, and it holds it. I'm not a big fan of these because they can come undone. They're super flexible, which is good in some areas, but in an area like this, it's not something that I would want to use. So then the second option here is another compression fitting, and so these are very similar to the ones that were upstairs in the tub. And so this piece goes on first, and it's a little bit tight, which is good. And then this piece will screw up onto it. And like we said before in the other compression fitting, there's actually a wedge shape in here, and as we tighten it, it gets tighter and constricts the black ABS pipe. But then what's great is that this is a converter piece. We can then glue convert to regular PVC. So this is the conversion that we're gonna use, and I would say it's one of the better conversions out there, and so that's why I recommend it. And then what's nice is after we come down with this pipe, like so, we'll be able to transition pretty easily into this white pipe here. So the only issue, as you can see here, is we had a pretty good connector right here, but then they went into this black pipe right here. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna cut this off. And this will allow us to just use a coupler, a PVC coupler, and go PVC to PVC. So the only transition piece we'll have is this compression fitting right here. So we're gonna get started. First thing we're gonna do is I like to dry fit everything first, and then work on actually gluing things together. This compression fitting also gives us quite a bit of flexibility moving it up and down. So this is a really good tool to use. This can kind of be your last piece, is to slip this on and get it in place after everything else is glued. So let's get to work here, and we'll start by kind of figuring out the right heights for everything, and then we'll cut this and then transition with our PVC. Okay, I wanted to explain a little bit about drain pipe support. And so up here we have this PVC pipe, and as you can see, it's supported a little bit over here directly, and then later on down the line. And so the issue is that we're gonna need to cut that out for a project that we're doing. And so in the meanwhile, I need to support the pipe either here or here to keep it up. And so it's very important to keep your pipes supported, A, so they don't sag, and then B, they are all very specifically, they have a slope downward, and so that makes sense if you want water to travel down and down through your pipes. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use this plumber's tape. It's basically just a galvanized strap, and you can use a screw gun and tin snips, and that should be all you'll need for this project. And so basically I can get my screw gun, and some screws, and I can go up to a joist and attach this. It can kind of be gangly at first, but you can figure it out. So I can go up here and attach this. End, and then I can wrap it around the pipe to give it support. So you can decide, you can sometimes like to wrap it around twice like this, and almost do like a crisscross so that gives it a little bit more support, and then just throw my screw in right there. And so the biggest thing is, it's not really an exact science, but just make sure that you feel that your pipe is supported well. That can't move. I'm gonna snip this here. Grab another screw and I can slightly pull up on it. And there we go. So now any weight, any gravity over time won't be able to pull this down and our pipe will be pretty supported. Then I will be able to remove this joint over here and our pipe won't fall and our slope will be kept as well. So whatever you're doing, whenever you're using drain pipe, make sure to support your pipe properly. There are a bunch of different hangers you can use. This is just one of the most commonly available, plumber's tape, and it's pretty easy to use. So we're about to cut this pipe here, and there are multiple different ways to cut PVC pipe. They have like plier-like tools that can actually clamp down with a blade and cut. We can use a reciprocating saw, a hand saw. The way I like to cut pipe for any of my pre-cut or new construction sections is on a chop saw, but obviously I can't get a chop saw up here. And so for this scenario, I'm gonna use a reciprocating saw. And basically the toughest thing about this is to make a straight cut. So I always say start off really, really slow and then work your way up all the way through the pipe. And I've already supported my pipe over here. And so I'm also using a metal blade. They make PVC blades and all that stuff, but I just wanna make a clean cut, and with smaller teeth, our metal blade will be able to do this. So I'm gonna start really slow, and the biggest thing is to make sure you have a 90 degree cut. Okay, not bad. And so I took it pretty slow. The next thing I need to do is just clean up the burrs here, clean up the goop as well, so that you can glue on the next piece. Okay, so I just made this cut right here, and as you can see, this is what my coupler is gonna look like. So this is kind of the dry fitting part of the process. So I'm gonna slip this guy on. The only thing you wanna be wary of is sometimes they get stuck on there, and just make sure that you can get the pieces off. The second thing is I always like to cut long. So whenever I'm measuring something, whether I cut this length long, that's fine. I can always trim it up later. Or whether I cut this stuff long, it's fine. You can always go back and trim something later. And so what I'm doing now is I'm just gonna align the pieces here and go one section at a time. So like I said, we do have some flexibility with this compression fitting. As you can see, I can go up and down almost 2 inches. And so that's something that we can use to our advantage. I'm gonna start low and then I'll be able to go up if I need to. So we're just lining things up with our eyes so that I can get, we're gonna cut this one first. So I feel pretty good about that. And now I'm gonna use a Sharpie and mark this. If you see from the other side, basically what I'm doing is I'm using this edge right here. That's where that pipe will go into. So if you can see, that's where you're shooting for. So you almost need to add, what is it, half an inch to your measurement? Half, 3/4 of an inch to your measurement, and that'll give you the right measurement. And like I said, it's always better to go longer than it is to go shorter. So like I said, I like to cut these things on the chop saw. So I'm gonna take this over to the chop saw now, and I'm gonna cut this up. The reason I like the chop saw is because you can get a very straight 90 degree cut in both planes. Also, you should really go pretty slow. You don't wanna chip the pipe at all. And besides that, the chop saw works really great. Okay, so we just finished dry fitting everything. We got this one cut, and then we cut this one as well. So, like I said, I like to just play around with everything while it's dry, make sure that everything is straight and how you like it, and then just check your slope as well. And then we can go about gluing everything. So I feel really good about this trap and then everything. So now we're gonna go and glue everything. All right, I just wanted to talk about gluing the pipes first. And so with PVC, there are a lot of different ways to do it, but one of the most acceptable ways is to use a primer. And the reason the primer is purple is just so that when the inspector comes, they can see the work that you've done. When they see purple on the pipes, they say, okay, they've used primer. Typically, the primer will give you a tighter bond within your pipes, and they're less likely to break. And so here we have just really the regular duty PVC glue. And so this version happens to be white. There are a bunch of different colors. There are orange, there's blue, and depending where you're working, whether it's in the States or abroad, the colors can be different as well. They also have a clear primer, but the reason it's purple, like I said, is so the inspector can see it. And so I would always say, no matter what, use the primer, and then at least use the regular duty glue. If you need a different type of glue, you can go ahead, get a blue one, which might be fast set or heavy duty. And then if you're using a different type of pipe, you might need a different glue as well. And so for this, basically you want to, this is just a coupler here, and so we're gonna prime both sides of it. And you wanna let your primer sit a little bit. What it's actually doing is softening the pipe as well as cleaning it. And then when the glue gets in there, the glue will almost be able to join to the pores, if you will. And so this stuff is very, it'll stain almost anything. So that's why I have this board down here to protect the surface I'm working under. And this stuff is also very juicy and very wet, so you don't need much. I'm just rolling it around, and you can actually feel the pipe almost drag a little bit. And that's actually what's happening is the pipe is becoming less slippery, and it's softening a little bit. So I can set this one aside and then move on here to the next one. And so it dries very quickly, which is fine. Don't worry about it drying. It actually should dry a little bit before you start. Show that one again. So like I said, the pipe, you can actually feel it softening a little bit. And that's it, we're done with this. And so as you can see, it's almost already dry. That's perfect. Now you can get out the glue. So same thing here. I usually like to start on the inside because there's less places for it to drip, and then go to the outside. Same thing, getting all the way around the pipe. Gonna let it sit, do another dip, and come to the male end. Go all the way around. Go ahead and check to make sure you've done it. And now, just join them together. So when you're doing it on the ground, it's pretty easy, but when you're up in the air, and I'm just giving it a little bit of a twist there to spread the glue. And so if you're working with larger pipe, 3-4 inch pipe, you'll notice that sometimes you'll push the pipe in and then release it, and they'll actually try to separate. And so I've had that happen. It typically happens with the bigger pipe. And so there are a few things that you can do. You can go ahead and grab some quick set glue if it just won't separate, or you can just sit there and hold it for a while. This stuff will dry pretty quickly. I would say in about 15 seconds, it's good to go. But if it keeps pushing apart, then go ahead and just hold on to it tight until it's not moving anymore. So we're ready to go put on this piece to the next. So we're gonna have to do a lot more gluing in the air, which is a little bit tougher because it can drip all over the ground and get all over the place. But that's pretty much the basics of gluing PVC. So all of your joints will be very similar, whether you're doing it here at a workbench or if you're doing it up in the air or under a trailer. So good luck. Okay, so we just finished gluing everything, and as you can see, this is what your inspector would be looking for, is he'd be looking for all these little purple spots. And so we did a pretty good job, and the last step here was we just adjusted our compression fitting. So this is where I said we had the flexibility, is this basically just slides, as you can see, up and down on the drain pipe. And so we can push it up and then tighten it. And so what's nice about this is that you can adjust your slope a little bit if you need to with the compression fitting. And so that's pretty much it. I'm gonna tighten this a little bit and then tighten this one, and then we'll be good to go. Thanks for watching our video. Go ahead and hit the subscribe button so you can get updated on all our newest videos. Also, go ahead and click the links below so you can see our social media profiles as well as our website.